स्टैंडर्ड 9th, सब्जेक्ट इंग्लिश. टुडे आई टीच यू द पोएम Somebody's Mother. दिस पोएम वॉज रिटर्न बाय मैरी डोब्रायन. ही वॉज बॉर्न इन 1816 इन द न्यूयॉर्क सिटी एंड ही वॉज अ वेल नोन अमेरिकन पोएट. दिस पोएम इज अ हार्ट टचिंग पोएम. He is trying to reach out through this about the sufferings and is compelling us to read this poem, and he makes us to think how realistic the life is, the age is. The boy in this poem shows compassion as the world is so busy but no one cares. This poem also includes with epitome of mercy, kindness, sympathy and compassion, which is also an inspiring story. As you know that there's a great proverb, it said, one good turn deserves another. We should never forget this proverb, because we always should help each other in their difficulties. So you see here, this young boy, he helps an old woman to cross the street. He realizes that she is probably somebody's mother. He hopes that when his own mother is in need of help, in his absence, someone like him will come along and help her. Now I'll just start with the poem. I'll just read the lines of the first stanza and explain accordingly. The woman was old and ragged and grey and bent with the chill of winter's day. The streets were white with the recent snow and the woman's feet with age were slow. Now the poem says that this woman was old with grey hair. She was wearing torn clothes. Her back was bent with the cold of the winter's day. Her feet were slow due to the age. The roads were covered with the recent fall of snow. And now I go to the second stanza. At the crowded crossing, she waited long, jostled aside by the careless throng of human beings who passed her by, unheeding the glance of her anxious eye. Now the second stanza says, the woman waited for a long time at the crowded crossing. The careless crowd pushed her aside and many people passed by without bothering about her anxiety. Now here is said that people are not bothered. They don't care. So no one is helping her to cross the road. Instead, they are jostling. They're pushing her. And no one is glancing as she is very anxious and wants to cross the road as soon as possible. Now I come to the third stanza. Down the street with laughter and shout, glad in the freedom of school let out, came happy boy like a flock of sheep, hailing the snow piled white and deep. Past the woman so old and grey, hastened the children on their way. Now here it said, down the street there were a lot of children. They were laughing, shouting, and there was a group of happy boys. They were very glad, but they were very free because they came out of the school. They looked like a flock of sheep. They welcomed the snow, which was piled up, which was very deep. They quickly, on their way, they passed the old woman, but no one paid heed to her. Now I go to the fourth stanza. None offered a helping hand to her, so weak and timid, afraid to stir, lest the carriage wheels or the horse's feet should trample her down in the slippery street. Now here it said, none of the boys offered her a helping hand. She was so scared, she was weak, she was afraid. She was afraid to move in the slippery street. But she had a fear that she is going to be crushed by the wheels of carriage or the horse's feet, because it made her difficulty to cross the road. So I go with the next stanza again. At last came out a merry troop, the gayest boy of all the group. He paused beside her and whispered low, I will help you across if you wish to go. So here finally, out of the happy group of children, there was a gayest boy who came out. He paused near her. Pause means he stopped for some time and told her softly that he would help her to cross the road if she wishes to go. So, come to the next stanza. Her raised hand on his strong young arm she placed, and so without hurt or harm, he guided the trembling feet along, proud that his own were young and strong. Then back again to his friends he went, his young heart happy and well content. And it means, she placed her old hand on the strong young arm. He guided her trembling feet, her shaking feet, along without allowing her to hurt or harm. He was happy that his own feet were young and strong. After taking a cross, he went back to his friends and happy, content with what he had done. So I go to the next stanza. She is somebody's mother, boys, you know. For all she is aged, poor and slow, and someone sometime may lend a hand to my mother, you understand. If ever she is old and poor and grey, and her own dear boy was so far away. Now, this boy, when he comes back, he explains to other boys that this old lady was somebody's mother. After all, even though she is now old, poor and slow, he hoped that someone sometime may lend a hand to his mother in his absence, because she too would be old, poor and grey. And finally, the boy went away. I go to the last stanza of this poem. Somebody's mother bowed low her head in her home that night, and the prayer, she said, was, God be kind to the noble boy who is somebody's son, pride and joy. Here it said, in her home that night, the old lady who was somebody's mother, she bowed her head low, she prayed, asking God to be very kind so that she can give him a lot of blessings to that noble boy who was somebody's son and pride and joy. Helping each other is very important. Having humanity is too important, because we all are human beings. So let us be human. Thank you.